million Americans are overweight. Finally, there is a healthy solution to help you lose weight. The synergistic effect of Plexus Slim and Plexus 96 taken together can help you lose more weight faster than you ever thought possible. Experience quick results and keep the weight off. People around the country are experiencing amazing results, and you can too. Plexus Slim and Plexus 96 have been shown to reduce binge eating and to help increase your willpower over food. Plexus Slim, also known as the pink drink, is a powdered product that comes in small, easy-to-open stick packets. Just tear open a packet and add about 12 ounces of water. Drink one time a day for weight loss. When you take Plexus Slim, it basically convinces your body and your brain that you've already eaten and that you don't need any more food. Your craving for food is gone. Plus, right now, you can try it free for 7 days. Just email your name, address, and phone number for a free sample to tryplexusfree@gmail.com. Tryplexusfree@gmail.com. Plexus Slim, the pink drink. It works.
What have I learned so far? I've learned that there is no one path that's right for everyone. I've learned that without my high school diploma, I could only do so much. My options were limited. I found a free personalized learning program with Learn for Life that has a flexible schedule so I could keep my job while earning my high school diploma. I found a new career training opportunity that would jumpstart my future. What have I learned so far? I've learned that I can change my life.
Are you 14 to 19 years old and looking for a free high school diploma program with flexible meeting times? This program allows you to keep your job or important family responsibilities while earning your high school diploma. If you've fallen behind on credits or dropped out of school completely, get back on track with free tutoring, a caring faculty, and one-on-one attention. For more information on how to reach your graduation goal, visit learnforlife.org. That's L-E-A-R-N, the number 4, L-I-F-E.org. Enroll today by calling 877-360-LEARN. That's 877-360-LEARN.
This is KCAA.
Would odors, mold, and mildew describe your basement or crawl space? It doesn't have to be that way. Transform them into a fresh, healthy, usable one with the technologically advanced Wave Moisture Control Units. The computerized operation maximizes moisture control and also expels harmful radon, combustion gases, and numerous other pollutants. Dehumidifiers are old technology that do nothing for air quality and waste energy. Wave units are intelligent, self-monitoring, do not need maintenance, and will save you hundreds in electricity. Wave units are still running effectively over 15 years. They've been tested and installed in public and military housing and by property managers nationwide. Buy a unit now, and if your home is not fresher and drier, you can return it for a full refund for up to 12 months. What have you got to lose? Call now 1-888-618-WAVE, 1-888-618-WAVE, or visit mydryhome.com. That's mydryhome.com.
Wave Home Solutions for a healthy, comfortable home.
Redlands Blueprint and Commercial Printing Company has been serving the greater Inland Empire for over 60 years. For all of your printing needs, from full-color printing to high-speed copying and everything in between, go to Redlands Blueprint and Commercial Printing Company. Their staff is committed to your total satisfaction. Great service isn't just lip service at Redlands Blueprint and Commercial Printing Company. It's the way they do business year after year. Having trouble finding drafting supplies? Redlands Blueprint and Commercial Printing Company still carries a complete selection. Redlands Blueprint and Commercial Printing Company is rated high in customer satisfaction by ValueStar, an independent rating company. For all of your personal or business printing, call Redlands Blueprint and Commercial Printing Company at 909-792-3478. That's 792-3478, or visit them on New York Street in Redlands off the I-10 and the Crosstown Freeway.
You're listening to KCAA, your good neighbor along the way.
Ready. Welcome to Cannabis Corner with Elmo Greenman
and Robert Porter
on KCAA 106.5 FM, 1050 AM, and oh my gosh,
102.3.
Yeah, 102.3 now, right?
Wow,
cool FM. Yeah, we got
climbing,
all kinds
climbing the charts.
Yeah, we got three possibilities to listen, and then also online if you wish. Our call online 1-888-909-1050. 1-888-909-1050, and this is brought to you by Green Med Entertainment
and I Love San Bernardino Productions.
KCAA, keeping cannabis awareness awesome. We would like to thank our sponsor, Kasha Harrington and Rehab Delivery, and their number is 1-760-953-9353. We guarantee our meds and work hard to advocate for our patients. By joining our collective, you're fighting for truth and change in our local government.
Indeed.
And also, we'd like to mention Cold Creek Organics and Mark Estermeyer on Highland and Palm with their number 909-709-6000 for your medicinal cannabis needs. Go check them out. Today we have Ray from Charlotte's Web and the Stanley Brothers.
Yeah, he'll be calling in here shortly.
Yeah, he's the California distributor, so he just was up in Colorado, and maybe he'll have some things he can share with us.
That's awesome.
And then we got Kid Dryden in the house.
Hey, how's everybody doing?
Excellent.
It's been about 2 or 3 months since I've at least a few months since I've been on here.
Yeah, it's always a fun time.
Hey, I appreciate you guys having me back.
Well, locals make a break Cannabis Corner, right? So we need performers.
You need the local people to come out, man.
Especially when you're performers. So if you're interested in performing on Cannabis Corner.
Hit us up.
Hit Kid Dryden up, too.
Hit me up. I'm an advocate for this. This is definitely a good spot to put your art out and also to be able to be well-informed on upcoming social issues, and especially through our city. It's pretty dope to be here.
Yeah, we were just at an evening with the mayor, huh, Elmo?
Evening with the mayor, another city event that wish we didn't attend.
me and Elmo talked about it today, and we decided that we were going to go. Yeah, and that was just us. So we rolled.
Yes.
And we show up, and there are posters. Weed, not greed. And it had nothing to do with us, dude. Isn't that cool?
That's awesome.
So basically, some Valley College students, a lot of them part of Generation Now.
They had people from Gen Now, people from the Inland Empire Progressive Alliance, Valley College. I'm trying to remember the other organization that was
a former Parks and Rec commissioner that was decommissioned for how he felt about certain things in the city.
Wow.
I mean, some of this stuff was very interesting to see people besides me and Elmo getting into this meeting and letting the mayor have it and his people. And why they were letting him have it was because of the letter that the mayor had the city council sign and the city manager and the city attorney and all the council and sent it to Trump.
I've read about that they wrote a plea like, oh, we need federal assistance.
I look at this as an act of treason. That's really how I look at it.
Wow.
Is that the city voters voted to overturn the ban. The state voters voted to allow recreational and medical cannabis.
Definitely.
And the city sends a letter off to people that want to continue the war on drugs, that want to build up the police state, that want to start opening up private prisons again, that want to, you know, have all this immigration reform. This could be real bad for the city.
Yeah.
They've opened us up to a possibility of some real futuristic police state type things possibly going on.
That's crazy.
So basically, as San Bernardino emerges from bankruptcy, we are striving to revitalize our community, but continuing to face many challenges, including violent crime, the letter continues. Many of these crimes revolve around illicit drug trafficking, including marijuana. In order to more effectively reduce crime, it would help our city to gain the support and partnership of the U.S. Department of Justice in our efforts to address illicit drug and marijuana trafficking.
That's scary. That's really scary that... You know, it may be nothing. It may be the worst thing that ever hit this country.
They're going to come under the guise of marijuana, but they're also going to get immigrants. They're also going to get anyone who's disagreeing with them or helping them or not helping them with what their cause is. This is going to be bad for us.
Homeless sweeps.
Yeah, the homeless were mentioned too.
I mean, that's really what I see. Neighborhood sweeps, gang related, homeless related, cannabis related, agenda related, whatever it is, just get them up out of here. Round them up, put them in this empty mall, use this as a detention center.
And it wasn't just us seeing this. There was 30 youth at this meeting. And then at the end, they all went out and protested. The mayor has opened a can of worms, and Elmo has been warning him the whole time.
He doesn't want to listen to me.
He doesn't. They don't want to listen. Now, you did talk to the city manager a little bit.
A little bit. I let him know that I was disappointed in that, you know, my taxes pay his rent.
And he's leaving. Yeah, he's kind of pretending like he's not leaving, but I don't know for sure. But the way he acted at the meeting, he had this this kind of an attitude a little bit, like, I don't give a damn. And that tells me he's leaving.
Yes.
Because he never acted like that before.
Yeah, somebody on the way out is fine.
Yeah, exactly. Well, who cares what happens? You know, but if you're staying, you are acting like a politician.
Yeah, you're acting way more civil,
So it seemed a little fake to me. Like he was a little more aggressive, like maybe the way he normally acts. Anyways, we're probably going to lose a city manager. And he didn't really know how to react to you saying, you called the army in on us.
Well, he says that I didn't, you know, not that I didn't say that. He says the letter, you know, wasn't an open invitation to bring in the army or the cavalry, as the Mormons might think about that may or may not be listening to the show tonight.
Yeah, the cavalry was going to come in to Salt Lake, and because they were marrying more than one woman, they were going to attack them. And they thought they were going to have their own country up there. So that's when all the Mormons got called back. So they were persecuted, and they were treated with disrespect.
And what did they do? They rioted.
Yeah, they got mad.
They set fields of farmland on fire and blamed it on the natives. And they killed American soldiers and blamed it on the Native Americans. And
What I was trying to show is that they were persecuted too during their time, and now it kind of feels like maybe there might be the persecutors now. You feel me?
Yes.
Like sometimes you forget about your past, and if you forget about your history, you're destined to repeat it.
Most definitely.
Terrible stuff. Like I just don't like that. We need resources. But to as a federal government, they should have been doing that all along in every possible way.
Yes,
that's some very obscure
true.
Letter off to the side trying to make a big deal. And you know what? It might be perfect for Sessions. This might be the perfect case study or ground zero.
A ground zero, a testing city to run whatever crazy kooking, you know, idea that they come up with to
Even during the election they brought up San Bernardino, multiple times. So like it already had its own national attention in that light, from what the attacks to when the continuous coverage of it to send a letter like that. I felt like they were just putting as much like Velveeta at the end of it, like a pond full of trout, just like, oh wait, I just please, if I could just hook one, like. And I think they're trying to get like the biggest fish's attention, and it's like it's scary that it's a possibility.
Well, here's Sessions. This is our new attorney general on crime and drugs. Sessions seems likely to take a harder stance than those of his predecessors. He spoke to reporters Monday and to the attorney general Tuesday about how he does not think marijuana should be legalized. He said that it will revisit guidance from former Deputy Attorney General James Cole on how federal authorities should act in states that have done so. Cole had written that in states with robust regulatory systems, federal officials could continue to leave the matter to local law enforcement, but states without such systems might face challenges from the federal government, Cole wrote. States can pass whatever laws they choose, but I'm not sure we're going to be better, healthier nation if we have marijuana being sold at every corner grocery store, Sessions said Tuesday. We'll have to work our way through that. Sessions said that increases in crime tend to follow increases in drug use, and he worried that about the beginning of a trend combating violent crime has been a signature issue for both him and Trump. Less than a month ago into office, Trump signed 3 executive orders, action directing the Justice Department to form a task force and to take other steps to target criminal gangs and reduce violent criminal crimes and attacks on police. So that's where we stand with this dude. He actually even mentioned marijuana specifically.
Yes.
He sounds really open-minded.
Yeah. if he didn't say heroin.
Right. Dude, I mean, how many heroin activists and meth activists are there? Like, you know what I mean?
Actually,
like, is that, like, you know what I mean? To be able to compare that realistically, like, if there's a national standpoint, like, of millions and millions of people standing behind marijuana, and they're, like, there's no other, like, I mean, maybe like a tiny fraction of like somebody that's active in like, oh, we should legalize opium or something like that. But like that percentage is so tiny compared to the people standing behind marijuana, behind people that are medicinally using it, even people that are recreationally using it. Like, there's such a large standpoint. Like, to be that naive in the thought process of we have to criminalize this and make sure that we continue to enforce it is just so narrow-minded. Like, that's being stuck in your own ways so heavily, like, or being bribed and paid off by
right.
by pharmaceutical companies to make sure that marijuana is not legalized. Like,
so
there's got to be an underlying factor behind
there,
it.
There like, is something, you know, at the state level that is being worked on to try and help us in this situation. There is an assembly bill. It's assembly bill number 1578. Okay. This is introduced by Joan Sawyer, and it's the Marijuana and Cannabis Programs Cooperation with Federal Authorities. Basically, this bill would prohibit a state or local agency, as defined, from taking certain actions without a court order signed by a judge, including using agency money, facilities, property, equipment, or personnel to assist a federal agency to investigate, detain, detect, report, or arrest a person for commercial or non-commercial marijuana or medical cannabis activity that is authorized by law in the state of California, and transferring an individual to federal law enforcement authorities for purposes of marijuana enforcement. And it goes on a little bit further and gives the definitions. And I'd like you all to go online and look this up again. This is AB 1578. This is basically to make California, I'm sure a lot of you have heard the term sanctuary city. This is make us a cannabis sanctuary
state.
Wow. State.
All right, we got a caller over there.
Right. Oh, our caller seems to be.
Yeah, we got a caller. Ray, are you on there?
I'm here.
Hey, how's it going?
Ray, could you tell us your last name, man? We have a hard time with that.
I don't blame you guys. The last name is pronounced Mirzabegian.
Mirzabegian.
All right. Perfect.
And you're from Charlotte's Web and the Stanley Brothers operation out there in Colorado, but you're a distributor out here in Los Angeles?
Exactly, yes, sir. Oh. So I'm with Charlotte's Web California, is the company.
Okay.
Could you tell us a little bit about what you think about Trump's and Sessions?
Well, first of all, thanks for having me on, guys.
Oh, you're welcome. I'm sorry to jump right into the nitty-gritty, man. But...
And listen, I don't know. I think it's time for change, and I'm just hopeful that whatever those two personally believe in is not going to be an agenda, but they'll bring on the change that's necessary in this industry, truly for the medicinal patient, actually, who I represent. So I don't think it's a matter of personal opinions or what those two personal opinions are. I think public demand is important. I think public demand is clear. Advocacy is stronger than it has ever been before. And I think people should continue to reach out to their representatives and make sure that, you know, their voices are heard. But ultimately, change is needed. I think we need some major change in policy in terms of regulation and legal and compliance and everything.
All right. Now, you just came back from Colorado?
No, actually, I haven't been there for about 3 months now.
Okay, so
how
are they planning on dealing with Sessions? Because the Stanley Brothers have a large operation, right?
They do, although I have to say, the Charlotte Web operation is regulated by under the hemp regulations. So they do have a hemp license to, under the Department of Food and Agriculture policies. You know, their plants are tagged as hemp plants. So they do follow a little bit different policies. But there's another side of the business that is THD by Stanley Brothers that launched recently in Colorado and is launching in California very soon. And, you know, it, just like everybody else, I mean, we are all sort of, you know, nervous and hoping for positive changes, and so especially in California, we'll see.
Last time that I saw you was, if I'm not mistaken, up at the Victorville High Desert Hot Box, correct?
Yes, sir.
So why don't you tell our listeners a little bit about what you told us there?
Absolutely. So I was speaking about the importance of pure and consistent medicine. You know, I was representing the CBD line of Charlotte's Web line of products. And, you know, when I present on that night, I was representing the pediatric community,
right,
which, you know, I call them the new generation of cannabis patients. And we have a lot of pediatric patients nationwide right now who, for them, it's a little bit of a different ball game. And you know, in my presentation, I was speaking about as cannabis producers and advocates and business owners, it is such a big responsibility to recognize this new generation of patients and how fragile they are and the importance of doing this the right way. You know, impurities and some of the cultivation practices I think could be harmful that exist nowadays.
Right.
And I think good change is needed. And you know, I just want to raise awareness of these patients and the importance of good policies and regulations that will somewhat ensure that the medicine is of a medicinal grade or clean and pure and tested.
Clean,
and
pure,
trusted.
Tested.
How do you make
consistent.
Sure? Yeah, that word. How do you make sure it's consistent?
You know, you have to be as consistent as possible. Obviously, every plant comes back a little bit different, right? But with mass production and with the current available technology, I think companies can produce large batches, large enough that will provide somewhat of a consistency, at least a phase of consistency, until the next large batch comes in.
Right.
So going back to Charlotte's Web, for instance, it is grown in a 28-acre outside field under the sun. And that's a lot of hemp plants. So
Indeed.
Yeah. So a large crop like that will create large similar batches when combined together and produced, which will be consistent for a while. And
you're
so
getting,
if you
like
keep
a...
your cultivation and manufacturing practices at its best, I think consistency follows. You know, some of these inconsistencies might be from inconsistencies in cultivation practices, for instance, or you know, the extraction practices or so on. But as much as possible, you know, in my presentation, I was talking about my daughter who has epilepsy and, you know, who is the reason why I got involved in this industry. I can tell you in the beginning when I was just experimenting with things, and which I am experimenting with things now too, you know, it's always a trial and error. But in the beginning, we were buying the same exact products and every single time they would be so different in potency, especially.
Right.
And that's what I was testing back then. And so I think it's important when you are, as a provider or a caregiver, if you are taking care of a patient who is as fragile as a 5-month-old child who's having cancer, for instance, or who has epilepsy, it's important to make sure that if something works for that child, then every single time the parent comes to you, you have to give them the same thing.
Right,
as possible,
right.
So that inconsistency can cause more seizures or withdrawals or breakthroughs and so on. And so I think people are realizing that, and there's a lot of good companies and there's a lot of companies that are getting better and better, and I'm so happy when I look around the industry nowadays how our industry is catching up and realizing the responsibility. So I think it, more and more of that has to happen now.
Wow.
Yeah.
And so your daughter is inspired you to start all this?
Yeah, so about my daughter is 13 years old now. She has what's called a Dravet syndrome.
Sure.
And I'm happy I'm going to talk to you guys about it today, because today is Rare Disease Awareness Day. And Dravet syndrome is a rare form of epilepsy that it affects 1 in 17,000 people now in America, I think. And what it is it's uncontrollable seizures, and no medication helps, no treatment helps. And these kids grow up having 120, 130 seizures a day, every day of their life. And, you know, Emily started at 5 months old. Her first seizure was about 2.5 hours after her vaccination shots. It caused a high fever, which caused the seizures, I guess. But all the way up to 2010 or 11, I had not heard of or experimented with cannabis. And we came up some documentaries, which sparked an interest and a hope, because at that time we had failed 13 medications. We took her and did stem cells and a whole bunch of other treatments. And so it sparked a little bit of hope and an opportunity to research, and that's exactly what I did. And at that time I was a college professor in the optics field, and you know, again, I had nothing to do with the industry. In 2011, I started hearing more and more about CBD, and a couple of other documentaries showed up until I saw CNN's Dr. Gupta documentary about Charlotte,
right,
which is when I really, you know, it woke me up, opened our eyes, and we started digging deep into it. And I can tell you, in 2012, Emily was on 4 medications, having multiple seizures every day. And by maybe about almost a year and a half ago, she's been off of every medication, and she has 1 seizure a week, and all she uses is cannabis right now.
All of them?
Yeah, every single med. So she is pharmaceutical free.
That's
the only
amazing
medicine she is on is cannabinoids currently. And so it helped us take her off of this, you know, medications. And these are a group of medications that are benzodiazepines, and these are pretty heavy sedatives
that
they give to these children. And unfortunately, what it does is, even if it was to control the seizures, which in our case it never did, but even if it was, a child that's growing up from 5 months old to 10 years old, they're under the influence of opiates and benzodiazepines. Their brains and their bodies do not develop. And so they have cognitive and behavioral issues and major delays, and most of them can't talk or nonverbal. They, you know, eventually they can't walk, or, you know, physical disabilities start to follow. And I don't think it's always the underlying disease or the condition. Sometimes it's the treatment that's causing it. For us, we were blessed to find this, you know, sort of in the right time. Emily is still somewhat nonverbal, but we almost saved all the other abilities. Physically, she's great. You know, she's a happy child because she's off of the meds and she's using medical cannabis every day. She goes to school, and, you know, her quality of life has improved by 100% ever since cannabis. So, and we obviously have over 70% reduction in seizures. So her success inspired me to get into this industry to help other kids in California, because the biggest challenge I had in 2010-11 was finding clean, pure CBD products, or THC products for that matter,
right,
that I would consistently trust to give to my child. And we've come a long way from there. As I said, you know, there's a lot of good companies now who have recognized the responsibility. And after Emily's success with Charlotte's Web, I used to go to Colorado and back every few weeks, and it was challenging. And, you know, the only choice was to move your family to Colorado and become a cannabis refugee, as they call them.
Yes.
And I decided not to. I decided to bring Colorado here, or the CBD, or Charlottesville here. So I proposed the opportunity to the Stanley Brothers, and, well, you know, joined them in a partnership. And we started growing Charlottesville in California in 2013. And we had, you know, it's very, these things that came together so quickly were so inspiring that I changed my career. For instance, in August of 2013, we went on Facebook and created a support group for parents. And we said, Charlottesville, California, and that's all we said. Anybody interested? And so we started a waiting list to see what kind of a demand there is so that we can prepare or start talking about manufacturing. From August 2013 till December 2013, we had 12,700 people on a waiting list.
Wow.
It was just insane. And so all of this together with Emily's success made me one of the biggest advocates for pediatric cannabis patients. And so that's what I do now.
Well, and you're doing a great job of it.
Heck yeah, no kidding.
Thank you, guys.
So what's your direction now? Are you going to continue to help the Stanley Brothers, or are they planning on moving into every medical marijuana state now? Or?
Well, the CBD line, because it is licensed under hemp, is being shipped across the country right now. So that is almost taken care of. Unless things change.
Right.
We are, with the Stanley Brothers, in partnership with the Stanley Brothers, we are launching a new THC line. It launched in Colorado. We are launching in California in about a month. It's going to be THC. The brand is SB, Stanley Brothers THC. And it's going to be, you know, the idea is everything we just talked about. We want to have a THC line that's the top grade, consistent, tested, pure, you know, everything. And it's a wide range of a line that offers an option for a child that only needs 1 milligram of THC per day, for instance. So we have a product for that. And we go all the way up to, RSO kind of oils for cancer patients . And so we'll start with oils and tinctures, and it will probably widen up to vapes and other products. So, yes, the plan is to branch out to legal states. I am only in partnership with them in California, and I represent them in California only, both in CBD and THC.
Okay. Awesome. And if I'm not mistaken, one of our sponsors, Rehab Delivery, carries some of your products?
Absolutely, yes. They're one of our best supporters out in the high desert area. I'm very happy to know them and work with them.
Awesome. So, you know, if you're listening and you're interested in learning more about Charlotte's Web, be sure to get in contact with the Rehab Delivery.
Yeah,
absolutely.
760-953-9353. And how would they go about getting a hold of you if they needed to ask questions or anything?
So, yes, I have opened a center in Burbank, California, where we offer consultations to cannabis patients, pediatrics and adults, and it doesn't matter what's the ailment or condition. And they can do consultations with Skype or telephone, or they can schedule an appointment and come in for personal consultations. Now, this will cover a range of products. It doesn't have to be just Charlotte's Web. And we will go deep into details of symptoms, and we'll look at medications they're using, and we'll talk about interactions and everything. And it's a good 1 hour of solid question and answer and detailed conversation to help these patients and families figure this out the right way. And to get a hold of me, I think the best way is to go to cwcalifornia.com. That's CW as in Charlotte's Web, California.com.
Okay. All right, awesome. And awesome. Go like that Facebook page for sure, right?
Absolutely. That's probably the easiest and fastest way to get a hold of me, actually.
Well, thank you. Thank you for liking our Cannabis Corner Facebook page today. I appreciate that.
You got it. I appreciate you guys a lot. Thanks for the time.
Yeah, we're just trying to make a difference here. And Elmo introduced me to you, and, man, you're really smart fellow, man.
Thanks, I appreciate it, man. Hey, we're all in this together, and if I can help you guys in any way, you know, let's get together and do this together.
Awesome. Thank you.
You got it. Thanks a lot, guys. Take care.
Take care.
You too, man.
All right. Well, should we take a break? This looks like a good time to take a break.
That was a great interview, huh?
That was amazing, man. There was no need to say anything. The way he was carrying that conversation was just – it was super intriguing, like everything he was
saying. He's got a lot of great information and his own personal story. Is touching and draws you into, you know, exactly why a lot of us got into this. We
very
have a personal
so.
Story that connects us.
That's great.
Hits from the bomb.
And we'll be right back.
On the carpet, steal it. you, Mary Jane. She never complains when I hit Mary with that flame. I light up the cherry. She's so good to me. When I pack a fresh bowl, I clean the screen. Don't get me stirred up the smoke through the bubbling waters, making it pure. So I got to take my hit and hold it just like Chong. I get the bowl and I reload it. Get my four footer and bring it on as I take hits from the bar.
I know, and then I just said that like really, and then this song's gonna be kind of aggressive, but that's okay.
What's up, Cannabis Corner? We're back here in Lynn Empire with Elmo Green Mans and Robert Porter.
Hey.
And we definitely would like to thank Carmel Row and the 420 Wellness Center.
Of course, we gotta always thank them.
Yeah, they do a good job, and they're always involved in stuff. Alrighty, alrighty. We got Kid Dryden in the house.
What's up, guys?
So you have a new song to play for us called Voices.
Yeah, huh? It's called Voices, and basically it's a way to represent all the different things that we constantly tell ourselves throughout the day, that whether it being that you're not good enough or other people themselves saying that to you. A lot of things just cloud the path that we're supposed to be taking, and the destiny and the driven, like the inner drive that we have, and we allow other things to overtake what we want to do. And this is kind of like a way to get back at those voices, to tell them basically like, listen, this is who I'm going to be, whether you like it or not. So if you stay, you know, focused on that path, you can get rid of those voices. So this is pretty much what I wrote to that.
All right. Oh, wow.
You know what I mean?
I don't. Sometimes I don't like those voices one bit.
You know, yeah, no, they piss me off. I'm going to say it. Those voices piss me off.
Totally. And like, and even if there's not somebody telling you what you can and can't do, a lot of times that person is yourself. Whether it's putting your own doubt in your mind about having fears that you might fail, like, you know, what you foresee can come to fruition. Like, and I, you know, if you see positive and you see growth, you will make that happen in your life. If you constantly see negative, you're going to get those rain clouds and you're going to get those constant speed bumps in your way. So
indeed.
This was kind of one of those ones where I kind of went back at those voices, like with my aggressive, like, man, this is not who I want to be. So that's kind of what I wrote this one in essence for.
All right. Let's hear it.
Yeah, I'm going to puff a little bit on.
I'm not mad at that, man. This, you know what?
Dab of the week this week. I didn't bring the nail.
Dude.
So we got some W vapes.
W Vapes.
Look at this, some banana cookies. Ooh. So I'm going to puff on that while you
perform.
Dude,
please do. Have multiple puffs. All right. And is there any way I could just get a tiny bit more mic? I feel like I'm partially deaf. Thank you, dude. It's all the loud concerts I've been to. There we go. Appreciate you. Ooh, there we are crispy. I appreciate that. Thank you, man.
Do you want to hit this before you go?
Sure, man. Why not? We are on the corner.
Cannabis corner.
He gets it. Thank you, brother. Appreciate it, man. So as I said, this one's called Voices, and it's produced by Ace Beats. And they're actually – he's one of a local another IE artist named Triz. They're going on a European tour that's about to come up.
Oh, wow.
So they are quite well-renowned, and they make amazing music. So this is one of the productions done by Ace Beats. And as I said, this one's called Voices. We are live on Cannabis Corner. We got Elmo hitting the W vape pen. And me ready to take a dab after this. Yeah. And it goes like this. All right. How much sleep you need to be the beast? I mean at your best, let me test and see. I testify before my death, what's left of life I left to ride. I never thought I'd leap. The voices heard, adjust the work, I work it out. I'm perfect now to shift the recipe. Be the best, I left my doubts and I give the switch to kid to get the best of me. Best of me, best of me. But I ain't been looking at the mirror the same. All these voices, noises, all these poison brains. Why you doubt yourself? Who put out your flame? Let me spark this lighter, then ignite the fire to your inner self. Beneficial, benefit for your inner health. Voice of wisdom, you get vision when winners help. Now I ain't do this just to prove this new state of mind. When the voice to do great is 2 days behind, well then it's you who ain't moving, you just staying in line. But if you lose, you only lose it when you're losing your time. So sign to this to turn piss to wine. Find that switch, then turn on the lights. I'm too lit, give by who hate on I. All these voices I'm hearing, I'm fearing I'll die. When the voices tell me don't stop, this the pinnacle, either get it or don't pop. Off the top, the best that I've seen, the rest just ain't me. Turn wet dreams to life, I'm wifing my queen. All these voices that spun yarn to gold, have jumped ship, I'm tips, then dumbed down their goals. They lived and let go, too different, too old, too twisted, too cold, I'm twisted, no hope. Voices, voices, I hear someone talking. Demons fighting, eagles, beasts are lurking. Weaving round us, I'm a peaceful walker. I see shadows burning by the heat of furnace. Keys are turning, doors will open. Voices tell me never fear the moment. All these people screaming, all these voices pointless, point to voices, voices, why my voice is golden. Voices, voices, I hear someone talking. Demons fighting, eagles, beasts are lurking. Dead on ringing, riding right among us. I'm a shadow walking by the peaceful burning. She's a turning, doors will open. Shadows tell us never fear the moment. All these people screaming, all these voices pointless, tens of voices, voices, why my voice is golden. I might go check me in. How they gonna leave me to face this alone? I said, I might go check me in. I hear voices ringing, thinking thankful I've grown. I said, I might go check me in. Look how they left me, I'm destined to grow. I said, I might go check me in. Homie, what was I thinking? These voices ain't know what lies inside of mine, as bright as mine. The lines are fine, but then my eyes get crossed. I cross the line to stop the time I waste. You never know how much time that you truly lost. Look around me though, no me to run my ship. If this is Captain's riding, you ain't high as this. Yet I still do work, but you stayed up. I put that voice to sleep and think of peaceful-ish. Every step I take, I make a forward leap. I've made leaps and bounds over that form of me. See me lonely, homie, know my circle small. I've been hard at work to keep the closest three. See them rolling, rolling, rolling up they sleeve. I've been rolling, rolling, rolling up my weed. I never battle-tested, voices battle me. But if you battle-tested, voices battle me. I said, and that's where that one comes out at.
Ah!
Man, I had one stumble, but when you just ride it, it's on the top.
Man. Much fun,
you know
love,
what I mean?
We love the new fire, though.
You know what I mean? I appreciate that, man.
So, do you like now? You have your own little store called Discount Directs over here in San Bernardino.
I definitely do. I appreciate that plug-in right after the wraps too.
And yeah. They you sell your wares on I Love San Bernardino Facebook group.
I do, which is a blessing for not only me. As much as I try to do with our business to give back to the community, I feel like the I Love San Bernardino and I Love San Bernardino Productions gives me also that opportunity and a platform to enhance what I do.
Yeah,
so.
And I would like to see that you give cheap goods to the community,
yeah,
man.
Entrepreneur.
It's one of those things that like – we found ourselves when we came up with the idea to start doing this and do wholesale and work and getting like to try to provide the community with the low prices. We found ourselves at a crossroads. Like, do we want to go? Because our jobs basically shut down on us without a final check and no way to really. We basically were left at a platform where, go sign up for another 9-to-5 somewhere or chase what it is that you want to do. And we took and had a water jug with about $300 worth of coins inside of it.
Oh, man.
I cashed it in and I went and bought my first wholesale load, and then we went to the swap meet. And I was like, all right, we're going to stay here. And we had one table and we sold everything that was on the table. And I was like, oh my God. Oh my God. Like, so we turned, like, I remember the first time we were able to turn that 300 into 500. And I was like, I didn't take a paycheck for like the first 6 months of us doing it. And I just always reinvested all the money back into the business. And I told myself the whole time, don't make it about money, make it about the people. You've been successful through this whole time, and you've always put faith in that the people are going to continue to like your business ship, like the way that you run the things, that your prices are low, and that you treat them with fairness. Like, if you use that as your business model and you treat people fair, it's hard for people to say a reason why they don't want to come shop with you. Like,
exactly.
And I've been in the store. It's not small. It's actually pretty big, and there's lots. It's filled.
It takes 10 people to feel small in there.
Yeah, wow.
But the thing is, like, every time we come in there, when I first was in there, I was nervous about taking that step about, like, oh, I hope, like I said, there's those voices, don't fail, like, don't, you know, what if people don't come, what if this, and I wasn't looking at the fact of, remember when you had that only $300 and change to get the stuff for the swap meet, and now you have a roof over your head, you have customers that are continuously coming to you, and people that we know by a first name basis, we've seen from when the mom was pregnant to where they're now through the diapers and like now into pull-ups, and we've provided them through the whole time. So like things like that to me are like, they mean something to us. We get invited to our customers' first kids' birthday parties, you know, like
that's awesome.
And like to me that resonates with me more than, ooh, did I get that extra 50 cents out of that person? Did I give that extra $1.20? Like at the end of the day, if you're counting every last nickel and dime, you're basically shortchanging yourself. Like, you really are. Like, there's no need to, there's plenty of money to be made. If you're working hard and you have a passion and drive behind it, there's plenty of money to be made. Just make sure that the first thing you do is take care of people and love people, because you're not here to make money, you're here to make connection.
Now you hear that, team? This guy's a stoner. He started his own business. It has nothing to do with cannabis. And he's being successful. That's something that we all should be admiring and trying to achieve ourselves.
Very inspirational.
Thank you, man.
And the day when you how many workers you got so far? Just you and your woman.
I got me and my woman, and we got a security guard.
Okay.
Who's my boy Q? And you know what? It's he was coming. He's a neighbor of mine that was coming down to my yard sales when I was doing a yard sale every so often, and him and his wife would come and buy diapers from us, and we started developing a relationship, and I was like, dude, you're my neighbor? Like, no way. He's like, yeah, right down the street, man. I was like, dude. Like, and we started hanging out more. And he's also a medical patient as well. And we learn from each other. And like, he's 42, you know, and I'm 27. And we were able to connect on a growth level and just friendship. And it was like, to see that I guess it's one of those things, like, it's all about perspective. It's not what you have. It's about the perspective of what you look at it as. Because no matter what, when you're chasing money, there's never going to be enough.
You'll never get there. You'll never catch the God of greed.
You never will, man. You'll just always want more. You're like, I made it to 100,000. Now I want 200. Now I want this.
It's an infinite number, so you could never achieve an end.
Money is only numbers, and numbers never end.
Yep.
That's 100%, man. Like, you got to really focus and remember what the core values are. Like, if your core value is making money, like, so be it. I completely understand that being your passion, but at the end of the day, that kind of leaves you with an empty feeling if all you have is money.
Those people tend to not be happy.
Yeah.
Unless they get more money. Yeah, and that's a vicious cycle.
Happiness fades rather quickly.
Yeah, especially when you get more money all the time, and it becomes like nothing to you. And there are a lot of people where money is nothing.
I've definitely seen that, you know, and I've seen where money is everything, where people are counting their last nickels and dimes to make sure that they can provide for not even them, for their child,
for the diaper,
for the
right?
diaper, for right. dude, for wipes, for something. Like, it's one thing that I try to focus on with the like I recognize need before my needs. So I recognize if somebody is in need and struggling, and if I have a case of a whole bunch of wipes and I see that you're struggling, you need something, I understand that, like, people, it's not a handout. It's, you know what, this will get you through till you have some money. I don't look at it as that way. Like, this will get you through just to get you a little bit by. Like, I can't provide,
this will
but
get
at this
you
moment,
that poop.
I can, exactly. Like,
one poop at a time, okay?
you can't be expected to be a constant provider, but you can also know that it's nice to know that somebody does care. You know what I mean? And it's not just, I understand it. People call them sob stories. People say this, like, oh, don't tell me you're stop. And sure, I'm sure some people got to buff up their ownness to be like, look how tough of a time I'm having. And like, and other people truly are experiencing extremely tough times. So that's not my job to filter through those people. Mm-hmm. Like, I think I look at it as if somebody needs help and if you are willing to express that to me, I don't think that I should turn you away. Like, we want to provide low prices. We want to help the community because everybody's struggling with their last dimes and penny and nickels. You know what I mean? So,
yeah, do cannabis consumers, like, come on in and visit them. You need any help you can get.
Dude, we even sell weed socks. So they're in there too. There's three packs of the herb socks. We got all kinds of stuff. We're like low key. We don't sell weed, but you're like, they might smoke. You know what I mean? We got to promote the business, essentially, because we keep it professional. We understand that not everybody's going to be turned on or like the view of that the people are marijuana consumers. But, you know, what people do in their private lives and what I do to make sure that I can provide for my family and who I care about is two separate things. So, like, if I can help the community continue to those low prices, and then at the end of the day I can go home and I can medicate and I'm taken care of and I'm fine, I think that's a win-win for everybody. So
it is. Amen. Well, it's been a win-win for me, let me tell you, for sure. He made me get started on PayPal and everything, and he's actually helping sponsor I Love San Bernardino.
If you have – somebody that's local that is trying to pursue something, support them, whether it's family, friend, any, just somebody in your community, because you know what, it's funny how many people will go and buy Beyonce tickets, J. Cole, Kanye West, and all that stuff
and spend
hundreds and if not thousands of dollars, but yet somebody who's grinding as hard as they can, local, right next to you, that you knew, you won't buy, whether it be a mixtape, a CD, support their website, buy a T-shirt, buy a hat.
You won't give them $2 just for a mixtape or pay $5.
Or you ask for it for free. Like, what?
Yeah.
What support? Like, oh, come on, bro, give me that. Like, dude, of course I would love to give everybody anything. Like, here you go. Here's a T-shirt. But, dude, at the end of the day, like, what is that truly supporting me with me giving it to you, like, and you being like, oh, thanks, dude. Like, I guess that people show support differently, but to truly support your locals is really where it's at. Like, you can't expect your city to get better if you're not trying to influence it to be better. Like, if everybody just takes off and leave, eventually you're left with nothing that's positive. Like,
so if you want to see some of his wares, Ms. Partey will be posting that up very shortly.
We will.
On I Love San Bernardino, and we'll put it right at the top.
Yep.
Discounts people, direct.
Now, we had to get through that because I was very proud of you, and seeing someone in the cannabis community start a business on cannabis is very important for people to see. But your specialty is rapping. Now, there's one song that I love a lot, so I'm hoping you can perform it for us today.
Which one is that one?
Uh-oh.
You should know by now.
Is it Forbidden Fruit?
Yes, it
okay.
is.
Okay. I don't have that file, but I do have the YouTube. It's on YouTube, I believe.
Yes, or yes. I played it last night.
Okay. It is on YouTube, if that's possible to stream from that.
Can you stream us Forbidden Fruit? Our engineer is on it.
Look at that, man.
So,
the guy behind the mic.
You did this video over in Highland on that old
on the
Model
old bridge.
A bridge.
Yes, sir. It's that's like one of the iconic shots over
is
there.
Is that Green Spot Road there?
Green Spot Road.
Yes.
Right before your way to get some jerky.
And now there's a new bridge there.
There
But there was an old one. Is it still there?
It's still there. They actually completely, like – detoured the whole road and left that as a standing, like, since it's been there forever, so.
I haven't seen that, but I've taken the new bridge just recently, so.
That's, honestly, when we went and shot the video, they completely reinforced the other bridge, because when we went there, it was, like, all redone, and it was, but they just said they can't have it, there's just a water line access road now, so, like. They completely shut it off to main traffic.
Well, yeah, it was dangerous. You could only fit one car on that beast.
You'd have
to
sit there and like flick headlights at other people. Oh. Like, your turn, my turn. Oh, okay.
That's like. Scary stuff. All right, well, we got it. We got it up.
We ready to roll?
Let's play.
So this is actually now 2 days ago. This was a year old.
Yes.
Wow.
2 days ago. Dude, it feels like a lifetime ago.
And the circus continues. How many people analyze what I write? Just out of spite. Well, maybe more if I control their whole life. The motor turning, I'm burning verses the back of their mind. A parasite, a paradox between the bastard they like. And that's me, hello, they already know who I be. It's Cat Double D, been puffing on a blunt full of weed. The only cracker who's been after the path to the mastery. From Master P to Kenny Keys and anyone in between. That's why I'm positive, bitch, you just the opposite, bruh. I swear, chilling my kimono with my moccasins up. I'm kickback, kid, I've been savage. Boy meets world and Topanga, there's been a bad pitch. From bad rappers, I manhandle and backflip. To grab asking and masking it with some bad dick. You can't attack this, I've been the best and been a threat to anybody that's nothing but the average. That's why I got a couple questions that I don't know. And I've been searching for the answer on the low, low. Get it right, how many people feel safe up in their own zone? And if they don't, bitch, you know that I'ma save a life. Forbidden fruit, I'm reaching up to the sky. See if the apple should fall, you know I'll give it a bite. Forbidden fruit, you listen to if you've been tempted to try. I'm giving God another chance before I'm planning to die. It's like, I try to tell him a night villain, I'm crazy. I get extravagant visions and visitors daily. Hello officer, I'm 5150 and having babies. Cause maybe the way I'm rapping just attracted a lady. Hey baby, wanna drive Mercedes. Sip a glass of wine as we're dining in our vacation. See the way I think is all a dream and I don't need to be complacent. But rapping is just a passion, never asked if you hate it. Am I relatable? Well I've been passing up the stuff and just to fuck up the whole gravy bowl. Bitch I'll never stay afloat. So when I drown I make the earth go round. It's like the weight is off my shoulders and I won't go down. So know if you've been writing, I've been tempted twice as much. Just know if you've been writing, I've been writing twice that tough. So if the shit should hit the fan, I'll have to back that up. Just know I'm stoned and all alone and never act that stuck. That's why I got a couple questions that I don't know. And I've been searching for the answer on the low, low. Get it right, how many people feel safe up in their own zone? And if they don't, kids, you know that I'ma save a life. Forbidden fruit, I'm reaching up to the sky. So if the apple should fall, you know I'll give it a bite. Forbidden fruit, you listen to if you've been tempted to try. I'm giving God another chance before I'm planning to die.
And that is Forbidden Fruit. Excuse me if I peeked on a couple times on the mic.
Oh, good job. We got a quick message from Normal here.
They wanted to have us shout this out before the end of the show.
From Jem Jem?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, man. So I guess the cup did get busted. I wasn't sure about what was going on up there. We're going to have to find out what happened. So IE Normal's next meeting, March 16th, 6 p.m., social 7 p.m. meeting. I'm assuming that's again at the Brew Rebellion over there, 3rd and Del Rosa. So IE Normal's next meeting, March 16th.
March 16th.
Make sure to follow us on Facebook, Cannabis Corner. I love San Bernardino.
San Bernardino Cannabis Reform page.
Yes.
Hit up Kid Dryden.
Hit up Discounts Direct.
Thanks a lot, Chris. Appreciate
I love San Bernardino.
Make sure our sponsors, Tarek Rosin, Rehab Delivery. Thank you very much. Till next week, Cannabis Corner out.
Out.
Yeah, and I will advertise it. Some call it Tampi. Some call it
KCAA Loma Linda. Listen on 1050 AM, 102.3 FM, and 106.5 FM.
Matter Radio Network.